The United Nations General Assembly has formally approved a deal aimed at boosting global cooperation to tackle rising migration. But the United States, Israel, Hungary and Czech Republic and Poland voted against the voluntary act. A UN General Assembly resolution enshrining the deal was adopted on Wednesday with 152 votes in favor and 12 abstentions, while 24 countries did not vote. U.S. President Donald Trump's administration has said the global approach to the issue is not compatible with U.S. sovereignty, and Washington did not take part in negotiations on the Migration Pact. Since July, the accord, which addresses issues such as how to protect migrants, integrate them and send them home, has been criticized by mostly right-wing European politicians who say it could increase immigration from Africa and Arab countries.
This document describes migration as if it would be the best thing what has ever happened to humanity. But this is not true. Migration is a dangerous phenomenon. Migration proved to be able to destabilize countries of source, countries of transit, and proved to put enormous security risk on countries of destination, among others, by creating parallel societies.
The GCM is a triumph of multilateralism. It is an assertion of sovereignty acting in concert with other sovereignties for humane objectives. But in no wise does it deny any particle of sovereignty's full extent and reach.
We believe the compact and the process that led to its adoption, including the New York Declaration, represent an effort to advance global governance at the expense of the sovereign right of states to manage their immigration systems in accordance with their national laws, policies, and interests. We are concerned that compact supporters, recognizing the lack of widespread support for a legally binding international migration convention, seek to use the compact and its outcomes and objectives as a long-term means of building customary international law or so-called soft law in the area of migration.